Now, after understanding the concept of buoyancy and buoyant force and the center of buoyancy as well, let's have a look at the concept of metacenter. Now, what is metacenter? Metacenter is but obviously a point about which a body will start oscillating when it is given a disturbance by a small angle. So, if you look at this figure, let us say this is figure A, which is before the displacement is given. And this is after the displacement is given, and that is the angular displacement. So right now the body is upright, floating in the liquid. So the center of gravity of this body will be over here, and the center of buoyancy, let us say, is over here. When we give it a small angular displacement in the clockwise direction, the center of gravity remains at the same axis. Okay, you have your B also over here. But right now what is happening is your B is shifting. Your B will shift. And this shifting will be, let us say, from B to B1. Because the majority of the, you know, the majority of the volume of the body or bulk of the body has now shifted or tilted towards the clockwise direction. So that is why the center of buoyancy will also shift, because as I told you, center of buoyancy is the center of gravity of the immersed part. So as the bulk of the body is shifting, which is below the water, the center of buoyancy will also shift. This means that at G you have a vertical weight acting, and at B now, or B1, you will have your buoyancy force acting. Now, what is this metacenter all about? This metacenter is basically a point which is the intersection of this original axis and a normal line which is drawn through point B1, and it is normal to BB1. So, if you draw this line, this point is called the metacenter. So, this is capital M. Okay, so metacenter is the point of intersection, of the original axis, okay, and normal drawn through B1, okay, and perpendicular to the line segment BB1. So that is your metacenter. So I hope you got this concept. Now we need to determine this length or this distance, which is MG or GM. This GM is called the metacentric height. This is called the metacentric height. So let's now derive a mathematical formula to calculate the metacentric height for a body which is given a small angular displacement and is floating inside a liquid in the next video.